They say freedom can't be measured, but what if it could? The first moment the engine starts, your heart rate spikes, dopamine rises, cortisol falls. The body prepares for risk, yet the mind feels peace. Data says your stress drops 28%, but the feeling goes deeper than numbers. Out here, there's no algorithm, no deadline, no constant self-narration. The noise fades. The default mode network, the part of the brain that keeps replaying your story, finally goes quiet. For a few seconds, you stop being a person trying to become something, and you just are. Every breath, every motion becomes permission to exist without control. Maybe that's why we call it freedom. Not because anything disappears, but because everything aligns. And tonight, we'll measure it, heartbeat by heartbeat, to see if the mind can truly ride its way back to stillness.
We look for freedom in the wrong places. We think it's out there, in the open road, in new cities, in breaking away from what we know. But the truth is simpler and more uncomfortable. The prison is not outside, it's inside the brain. Modern life traps us in an invisible cycle of control and repetition. The same routines, the same notifications, the same thought loops. The default mode network, the system that keeps replaying our personal story, never stops talking. It whispers reminders of who we are, what we must do, what we might lose. This constant inner narration feels like consciousness, but it's actually captivity. Our ancestors fought real predators. We fight our own predictability. The brain evolved for survival, not for serenity. It craves novelty, but clings to safety. It rewards what's familiar, even when it hurts us. Cortisol rises when we're trapped in monotony, yet we call it stability. Dopamine fades when there's nothing new to explore, yet we call it comfort. So we chase substitutes, scrolling, buying, planning, anything to feel movement without moving. But it never works, because freedom is not found in escape, it's found in engagement. That's why riding feels different. The moment the engine hums, the feedback loop resets. The chatter of the DMN quiets, the body sinks with motion. The illusion of control breaks, replaced by awareness. On the bike, you're no longer the narrator of your story, you're the pulse within it.
Freedom, it turns out, isn't something we find, it's something we train. The feeling of liberation is not an emotion that comes from escape, but a neurochemical pattern the brain learns through experience. Every ride becomes an act of retraining the mind. When you face risk and stay present, the brain's old wiring, built for fear and prediction, begins to soften. Dopamine rises with movement, signaling novelty and reward. Cortisol, the chemical of control and tension, drops. And slowly the brain realizes that safety is not the absence of threat, it's the mastery of response. That's why motion heals. Each curve, each breath becomes feedback between biology and awareness. The locus coeruleus norepinephrine system, which balances alertness and calm, recalibrates with every ride. The more the world speeds up, the slower the mind feels inside. Focus expands, breath steadies, the heart synchronizes with motion. It's measurable. HRV rises, stress hormones fall. But what truly changes is invisible. Your relationship with uncertainty. Fear no longer drives you, it informs you. Control stops being an obsession, it becomes a rhythm. This is how freedom works in life too. The problem isn't pressure, it's how we meet it. The more we resist what we fear, the tighter it holds us. But when we move with it, like a rider leaning into the turn, fear becomes momentum. Problems stop being walls and start becoming mirrors. They show us where we're rigid, where we've stopped learning, where the illusion of control still runs the show. Riding teaches the simplest, hardest lesson. The road doesn't have to change, you do. Think about it. Life, like the ride, gives feedback in real time. The wobble, the resistance, the misalignment, they're not failures, they're data. And awareness is the calibration tool. When the mind stops fighting for certainty and starts observing its own patterns, something profound happens. Clarity emerges without force. You begin to design your days the way you navigate the road, with adaptability, attention, and grace. The science calls this self-regulation, but to the rider, it feels like freedom. Because it's not the disappearance of limits, but the harmony within them. The bike still obeys physics, the brain still manages chemistry, yet the experience becomes transcendent. You're no longer chasing peace, you're creating it, one heartbeat, one decision, one line at a time. Every ride becomes a rehearsal for a more conscious life. You learn that the goal isn't to remove difficulty, but to respond differently to it, to look at each challenge as a curve, not a cage. And when you do, something extraordinary happens. The external world doesn't shrink, but your awareness grows wide enough to hold it. That's what freedom feels like. Not control, not escape, but coherence between who you are and how you move through life.
In the end, riding is not about machines or miles. It's about learning how to live with motion. The road becomes a metaphor for a designed life, one that's not ruled by fear or control, but shaped by rhythm and awareness. Every curve asks the same question life does. Will you fight the turn or flow with it? Those who resist tighten and lose balance. Those who yield align. The paradox is timeless. Surrender is what creates mastery. Freedom, then, is not rebellion. It's harmony. The same balance that keeps the bike upright keeps a life steady. Too much control and you lose curiosity. Too much chaos and you lose direction. Riding teaches that the art of living is not choosing one or the other, but finding the space in between. That's where clarity lives, in the motion that doesn't rush, in the focus that doesn't strain, in the breath that doesn't chase. So maybe we ride not to escape the world, but to remember how to be in it. Because the feeling of freedom is not granted by the road, it's mirrored by it. The throttle becomes a pulse, the wind a teacher, the horizon a reminder. You don't need to run from life to feel free, you just need to move through it with awareness. That's the deeper ride, the one that never ends when the engine stops.